Daniel. I'm 21 years old. This is my YZF 450, 2013 model. I've been riding for about 6 or 7 years now. I remember starting off one Christmas when my sister, she got heaps of Christmas presents and I got barely anything, and I was really upset, and I went downstairs and discovered that I had my first motorbike waiting for me in the shed. Ever since that day, I've just been hooked. Always wanted to be out on my bike, out in the bush, having fun with my friends. Something about it, once you're on there and riding hard, you get a sense of adrenaline and you just don't want to stop. Probably one of the main influences that has made me want to ride even more is one of my good friends, Steve. He's probably about 60 years old now and he still rides better than anyone I know. He's always willing to help any of us out, teach us new skills. Lucky where I've grown up from, because there's plenty of riding around Newcastle in New South Wales. From the beach over at Stockton, all the way out to the bush at Sugarloaf, as you can see in the background. Pretty much you name it, there'll be somewhere to ride. Probably my favourite thing about riding bikes is just the freedom. Like, you can, no matter where I am riding, you can just see a hill, just shape it, shape a lip in it, just, yeah, freedom, get air, do whatever you want really. It's still all up to you, where you want to take it and how high and how hard you want to ride. So always out there willing to push myself to the next step, always progressing to make myself better. See, everyone who I ride with, we try and push each other. One of the main things is though, always be safe, always wear safety gear, helmet, goggles, gloves, boots. It can be a very dangerous sport at times, as I've had many crashes over the years. I was riding one day and I said to myself, oh, I'll just do one more lap. And I took my chest armour off and came off and put my handlebars through my chest and I broke my ribs. But for my passion for it, I always kept back on that bike.
My name's John Magona. This is a story of a little man who had a little career in a big organisation and a lot of fear. My registered number was 39692. I attested from the Goulburn Academy in August 2003 and was confirmed a constable in August 2004. I started general duties at Campsie Police Station in Sydney for 3 years before going to Highway Patrol Parramatta for 5 years. General duties at Tugger Lakes for 1 year.
What motivated me to join the police force is because I'd always wanted to join the cops. Ever since I did my apprenticeship, and then I was going to join the cops, join highway, because the motor vehicle trade would have been handy for them, which it wasn't, because they didn't give a shit. If you're a mechanic, or you weren't a mechanic, you needed to be an academic to join today's police force, and I wasn't an academic. The expectations, well, the New South Wales police force is far too political and far too touchy-feely. So when it come down to the facts of doing the job, and the job's all about common sense, it's, you can have the most educated half-wit in the world, but he won't have any common sense, and the police force doesn't acknowledge that. They just want over-educated buffheads, and they're not interested in common sense and life experience. That's where the job gets left behind. So when it comes to my expectations, which were about common sense-based policing, it's not the way it is. It's about ticking and flicking and giving all the politically correct answers to solve their statistic responses. The only rewarding thing of the police force was nothing. There's no mateship in the cops. The expectation of everybody being mates and looking after each other and sticking up for all the everyone else in blue is all bullshit. Because it's every man for himself, especially when it comes to the hierarchy. It's very, very difficult if it's at all that you can find camaraderie within the to and fro ranks of the cops. It's being bred out of today's policing. They don't want it. They believe to have transparency, they have to have every man and his dog as a single unit, and to be spying on their fellow workers. There's more horror in the cops than there is rewards. Yeah, the one that sticks to my mind was the Bill Cruz shooting at Bankstown. A police officer that was shot dead by friendly fire that I attended. That would be one of the most horrific ones I'd ever been to. I'd seen plenty of paramedics working on people trying to keep life in them with gunshot wounds and stab wounds and the bits and pieces, but it's not until they're actually working on a fellow police officer that reality strikes home. It has a lot of effect in a lot of different ways. That kind of, when that incident occurs, you have cops pissed off with cops because he jumped up, he stood up, and one of the boys that was covering shot him. You have the bureaucracy, which doesn't want to tell the truth about why it happens and how come it happens. You've got lack of support from superior officers with a suck it up attitude that comes out. It affects morale in a lot of different ways. It's the first time I'd ever been involved in a critical incident where they actually did offer counselling, and they had counsellors wandering around the station. It's been referred to that 6 months frontline policing in a Sydney LAC, a Category 1 station, is the equivalent of 12 months service in Iraq. But the police, New South Wales police hierarchy and politicians refuse to accept it. But the studies show that they're overworked. Frontline cops are overworked, way overworked. I left the police force diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder, which the New South Wales Police Force refuses to acknowledge with any of its members, or past or previous. I currently know of several serving members who have post-traumatic stress, but the police force in its fucking arrogant determination to blindside everybody that there's nothing wrong. And it's a big thing. Being shot at twice. I'd apprehended how many people with knives and batons. Done so many good deeds over the years for people that were injured or just needed help. And that's how they reward you, by kicking you in the butt and throwing you out the door and slamming the door behind you. They don't want to know. It needs to change. It's time that they acknowledge and they actually look after their cops that have medical issues like this, like post-traumatic stress.
My name's Joseph Carlos. I studied a Cert 3 in metal fabrication and welding at the Gosford campus of Hunter TAFE.
My name is Grant Ryan. I studied Electro Technology Certificate 3 at the Hunter Institute of TAFE Glendale campus.
My scholarship really helped. With that extra $2,000 to put towards fees, it meant that I could start my diploma in engineering a lot quicker and get my whole career on track.
I used the scholarship to help pay for some of the TAFE courses in the Advanced Diploma for Electrical Engineering, ultimately to reach my goal of project management in electrical engineering.
I'm Stephanie Ellis, doing fitting machining through Hunter TAFE at Maitland campus.
My name's Broden Dalton. I'm a third year fitted machinist. I really appreciate the scholarship from HMA, and it's definitely helped me further my trade.
It helped me with giving confidence in my abilities, and that it's the right career choice for me.
My plan is to go to university and study a diploma in civil engineering.
I'd like to thank the Hunter Manufacturing Awards and Hunter TAFE.
Thank you HMA for the scholarship and the opportunity to further my study.
I'd like to thank Hunter Manufacturing Awards for the opportunities that they've given me.
Thank you Hunter Manufacturing Awards for the scholarship. It has really helped me in my career.
player two has left. You do know the front door was open again last night. I'm not saying it was you.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything. What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have.
My son, the day you were born, the very forests of Lordaeron whispered the name. Arthas. Wisdom and strength. And I know you will show restraint when exercising your great power. But I tell you this, for when my days have come to an end, you shall be king.